Hi friends, my name is Radhan. So in this video, we'll discuss about the lambda expressions, the powerful topic. Okay, lambda expressions, right? The previous videos, we done the anonymous inner classes, like nested classes concept. So to understand the lambda expressions in more detail, can please check the anonymous inner classes once. Can please check what? Anonymous inner class. Otherwise, directly you can understand the lambda expressions, that is not a problem. Okay, good. So the main intention of lambda expressions here, lambda expressions will reduce the length of the code. It will reduce the bytecode actually. Okay. The main intention of lambda expressions, reduce the length of the code, reduce the bytecode, right? That's it. To write some points, I'm using edit plus. Go to the file menu, click on new. So click on Java. Okay, so here let me write some point. The topic is called what? Lambda expressions. Okay, lambda expressions. Clear? Lambda expressions here. So this is the video class number one, lambda expressions, right? So the video class one. Good. Video class one. I'll give some basic introduction regarding what is a lambda expressions. The main intention of lambda expressions, only 2 points here. One is what? So length of the code. Okay, length of the code reduced. Okay, length of the code is reduced. The second one is what? Bytecode is reduced. How it is reduced in length of the code byte coding, we'll discuss practically. So second one is what? There is no bytecode reduced, right? Bytecode reduced, that's it. So before going to the lambda expressions, first of all, we must know functional interfaces in Java. Which interface here? Functional interfaces in Java. What do you have functional interface here? The interface. So as you know, interface, right? Up to Java 7th version, interface allows only which methods here? Up to Java 7th version, interface allows only which methods? Only abstract methods, right? Only abstract methods. From Java 8th version onwards, interface allows abstract methods, and interface allows default methods, interface allows static methods also. Okay. What is the point here? From Java 8th version onwards, interface allows what? Default methods, abstract methods, and static methods, right? Up to Java 7th version, interface allows only abstract methods. Okay, so lambda expressions, which is introduced in Java 1.8 version here. Lambda expression, which version? Java 8th version. And functional interface also introduced in Java 8th version. Java 8th version. Then, sir, what is functional interface? The interface which contains only one functional method. What do you mean functional method? Abstract method is also known as functional method. Which method? Abstract method is also known as functional method, right? These are all theory points. Don't waste the time in front of the video. Try to get the clarity and subject. Take the pen and paper, note down the points. Lambda expression main intention is what? Length of the code is reduced, bytecode is reduced. How it is reduced in the code, you will discuss practically. So to understand the lambda expressions, first of all, you must know the functional interfaces. The interface contains only one method, is called a functional interface, right? Java 7th version onwards, interface allows only abstract methods. From Java 8th version onwards, interface allows abstract methods, default methods, and static methods also, right? That's it. So, that's all, right? Good. The next point here, what do you mean functional interface? The interface which contains only one functional method. Okay, the interface contains only one functional method is called functional interface. Nothing but the interface contains only one abstract method. It may contain default methods, it may contain static methods, no issues, but it must contain one abstract method. So no, that's it. So interface IT1. So here I have void M1. This is functional interface or not? Exactly, it is valid, right? Obviously this is functional interface, right? No issues. Okay, let me declare the case 2. Case 2, void M1 is there. It is having some default method also. Default void M2. Tell me, this is functional interface or not? Yes, valid. Because it contains one abstract method, right? Exactly. If you go to the case 3. Case 3 is, it contains one abstract method and it contains a default method. Default void M2. Okay, default void M2. It contains one static method. Static void M3. Then this is also what? Perfectly valid, no issues. Sir, no issues, right? Good. If we take one more example, I declared case 4. What is case 4 here? I declared void M1, I declared void M2. These both are abstract methods, right? But functional interface contains one abstract method? not at least, yeah, the functional interface contains only one abstract method. The interface contains only one abstract method that is called functional interface. But here, how many methods are there? Two methods, right? We will get error message. These points are clear, huh? First point is what? The interface contains only one abstract method. This is called functional interface, no issue. Only one abstract method, no issue. It may contain default methods. It may contain defaults and static methods also, no issues. But the interface contains only one abstract method. That is called what? Functional interface. Now the functional interface is clear, right? Once the functional interface is clear, the lambda expressions will provide implementation of only functional interfaces. Lambda expressions will provide the implementation of only functional interfaces. Okay, so there is, wherever the functional interface concept is there, lambda expressions is there, right? Good. Let me develop one application here. So to write the practicals, I'm doing the practicals by using edit plus. Go to the file menu, click on new Java. So here write the application. Okay, first let me take the functional interface. So interface IT1. So it contains only one method, assume disp method is there. If you want full screen, just click on full screen here. Disp is functional interface, right? That's all. Okay, so the class test is there. First let me write the application with anonymous code. What is the application with anonymous class? Application with anonymous. What the application with anonymous is? Don't take the implementation class, directly create the object of interface. Directly create the object of what? Interface. It seems to be interface object, but this is interface object or not? No. Internally X class is generated, that X class implementing that interface, that X class object will be created, right? That X class is called anonymous class. If you want that information, check the previous anonymous classes topic, anonymous inner classes topic. Very clear, huh? This is the previous videos, just you can check the previous videos. Next day classes, video class number 6. It is called anonymous, right? Good. See, first I will write the application with anonymous, then I will write the application with the lambda code. Application with anonymous says what? Directly create the object of interface, right? IT1 I equal to new IT1 of open brace, closer brace. Semicolon is mandatory. And it contains one method, right? Directly write the implementation here. Public void m1 method, parenthesis. Okay, so here you can write the system.out.println of. So this is so anonymous. This is anonymous, right? That's it. Simply you can call the i.what m1 method, right? That's all. Not m1 method, yeah? This is a disp method, right? That's all. Here all simply you can call the method is called disp. That's all, guys. This is called just reference variable, right? This is reference variable, this is anonymous approach. Okay, the same application, let me save this code, tester.java file. Okay, same application with lambda, right? What the lambda expression says, IT1 I1 equal to, this is called anonymous, right? This is called anonymous. In the place, directly, IT1 interface contains so many methods here. One method, right? Which method? Abstract method, right? That method implementation directly you can write here. Okay, that method implementation directly you can write here. The first one, we have to take the arguments. Arguments, how many arguments? Zero arguments. But the lambda syntax is, what is the syntax of lambda? What is the syntax of lambda here? So first one is the arguments. Here you can make the arguments, arrow. Here you can make the expression. Arguments, this just arrow, expression. This is a syntax of what? Lambda. Okay, so here, so IT1 I1 equal to, here directly write the implementation of disp method. Disp expecting how many arguments? Zero argument, right? Here zero argument. Simply can make the arrow. Okay, make the arrow. The system dot out dot, tell me system dot out dot, println, right? Println of, so simply can write message, this is what? Lambda, completed, guys. This is called what? Lambda, right? That's all. Simply can write the i1 dot, the method name is called disp method. i1 dot disp, right? That's it. Complete, guys. Simply to run this code, just open the command prompt. So where is the file here? Local disk E, right? Local disk E. How to compile here? Java C. The application name is called test.java. Code is compiled fine. Java, the class name is called tester. This is anonymous. This is lambda, right? Exactly. Ratan sir, you said the interface contains only one method. The implementation directly can write here, right? I'm saying like that. But Ratan sir, tell me, my interface contains two methods. If your interface contains two methods, that is not a functional interface, right? The functional interface contains only one method, right? Then only lambda expressions will working. Lambda expressions will work only in case of functional interface. Functional interface obviously contains only one method, one abstract method. Exactly. That's all, guys. Then, sir, but I want the two multiple lines of logics. Then what I have to do? So if you want the multiple lines of logics here, simply can make the I2. Take these logics within the braces actually. Within the braces. Within the braces, you can declare how many statements you want. You can declare all the statements here. So no, that's all. This is lambda 2. This is I'll make the lambda 1. This is lambda 2, right? Then simply can call the disp here. I2.disp or not. That's all, guys. That much simple lambda. Okay, code is compiled fine. Semicolon. This line must end with what? Semicolon, right? So code is compiled fine. Java, the class name is called what? Test class. This is lambda 1, lambda 2, like that, right? Got it. We clear that this is application with the lambda example. Yeah. Any doubts? So finally decided lambda expressions will provide the implementation of only functional interfaces. Very, very important. Yeah. In multi-threading, in collections, nowadays we'll the frequently used concept is lambda expressions, right? Good. You want explanation one more time? Yes, sir. I will give the explanation one more time. Remove the anonymous, sir. Not required. Leave it. Good. Lambda expressions will provide the implementation of only which interfaces? Functional interfaces. Here, directly IT1i, reference variable required. After equal to, I want directly provide the implementation of this method. This method expecting how many arguments? One argument. Directly can write the argument here. Arrow. What is the implementation here? Directly can write the implementation of that method. What implementation here? Simply can write, this is my good morning, right? So no, this is my simply good morning. That's it, completed, guys. I dot simply can call, which one I have to call? Disp, right? That's it. Then code is compiled fine, no issue. Java, the class name is called what? Test class. Good morning is printed or not? That's all. So this is the example number one. Example two regarding anonymous class. Which one? Lambda expressions. We clear? That's all about your lambda expressions concept here. So in this video, just I'll discuss example one here. In the next video, we'll discuss one more examples. I have the 5-6 examples here. We'll discuss all the examples. In the first video, just I'll give the basic introduction regarding anonymous lambda expressions. The main intention of lambda expressions, reduce the length of the code, reduce the byte code. So lambda expressions will provide the implementation of only functional interfaces. What do you mean functional interface? The interface contains only one abstract method, that is called functional interface. It may contain default methods, it may contain what? Static methods, right? Good. If you know the anonymous classes, what are the anonymous classes? Internally X class is generated, right? It means internally bytecode increasing. But lambda expressions, there is no bytecode. There is no bytecode and length is also one line of code, right? That's all. So that's all, guys. If you have any questions, just write the comment mode. Write the comment. And thank you, guys. Thanks for watching. Like the video and comment the video. Subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. Thank you, guys.